Welcome, Storytime Buddies! We're so glad you could join us! Sweet Pea is picking out more of his favorite books to read. Do you like story time?
Yeah!
That's great! In the first story, Pete asks everyone what to wear to look cool at school. Let's find out how he looks as we read Pete the Cat, Too Cool for School by Kimberly and James Dean. Pete wants to look cool. He asks everyone, "What should I wear?"
"Wear your yellow shirt," his mom says. "It is my favorite."
So Pete does.
"Wear your red shirt,"
Pete's friend Marty says.
"It is my favorite."
So Pete does. "Wear your blue shirt," Pete's brother Bob says. "It is my favorite." So Pete does.
"Wear your long pants,"
Pete's teacher says.
"They are my favorite."
So Pete does.
"Wear the shorts with the fish,"
Pete's friend Callie says.
"They are my favorite."
So Pete does.
"Wear the polka dot socks,"
the bus driver says.
"They are my favorite."
So Pete does.
"Wear the cowboy boots,"
Grumpy Toad says.
"They are my favorite."
So Pete does.
"Wear the tie with the stripes,"
Emma says.
"It is my favorite."
So Pete does.
"Wear your baseball hat,"
his coach says.
"It is my favorite."
So Pete does. Pete puts on all the clothes. Does he look cool? No, Pete looks silly. He also feels very hot. Pete goes home. He changes his clothes. Pete puts on his favorite shirt. Pete puts on his favorite pants. Pete puts on his favorite socks. Pete puts on his favorite shoes. Pete puts on his sunglasses. Pete says, "Now I am cool." If you want to be cool, just be you. Did you like that story?
Yeah!
So did I. Pete learned that he looked cool just by being himself. In the next story, Pete is playing in the big game. Let's find out who wins as we read Pete the Cat, Play Ball, created by James Dean. Here comes Pete the Cat. Pete has a mitt. He has a bat and a ball. What will Pete do today? Pete will play baseball. Today is the big game. The Rocks are playing the roles. Pete and his team get set. They play catch. They take turns hitting. It is time to play ball. The Rocks bat first. Pete waits for his turn. Crack! The batter hits the ball. He runs to first base.
Way to go!
Pete cheers.
Batter up,
says the umpire. Pete goes up to bat. The pitcher throws the ball. Pete swings the bat. He misses the ball. Strike one. The pitcher pitches again. Pete swings too high. Strike two. The pitcher winds up. He throws. Pete strikes out. But Pete is not sad. He did his best. Pete's friend Ben is up. Ben hits a home run.
Way to go!
Cheers, Pete. The rolls go up to bed. The rocks go to the field.
Crack! Here comes a fly ball! I've got it! Calls Pete.
The ball hits his mitt. But Pete drops it. He is not sad. He did his best. Another hit! This time Pete catches it, but he throws it too far. Pete is up at bat again. He wants to hit the ball. The first pitch is too low. Pete does not swing. Ball one! The next pitch is too high. Pete does not swing. Ball two. The third pitch is inside. The fourth pitch is outside. Pete gets four balls. Pete wanted to get a hit, but a walk is cool too. The next batter gets a hit. Pete runs as fast as he can. Pete wants to score, but he is out at home plate. Pete is not sad. He did his best. The game is over. The Rocks win 6-3.
Way to go! Calls Pete.
Good game!
The Rocks say.
Good game!
The Rolls say. Pete did his best. He had fun. What a great game! That was a great story. Pete didn't hit the ball, catch the ball, or score for his team, but he was not sad. He was proud of himself because he did his best. Good job, Pete! Let's climb into the next story. Pete and his friends try to help the spider up the spout. Let's find out how as we read Pete the Cat and the Itsy Bitsy Spider by James Dean. One day, while playing outside with his friends, Pete the Cat spotted something cool.
Look!
Shouted Pete.
Wow, it's so small, said Gus.
It's an Itsy Bitsy Spider, said Callie.
The Itsy Bitsy Spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. Pete and his friends knew just what to do. Everyone cheered on the tiny spider. Pete the Cat said,
"Try again, Itsy Bitsy Spider."
So the Itsy Bitsy Spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. Pete said,
"Don't give up yet!"
They all cheered louder this time. Again the Itsy Bitsy Spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain, and Pete and his friends shouted,
"Go, Itsy Bitsy Spider!"
And the Itsy Bitsy Spider kept climbing up the water spout. Everyone celebrated, and the spider took a bow. With the help of some friends, the Itsy Bitsy Spider never gave up, even when the odds were against her. Did you see that?
Yeah!
With the help of Pete and his friends, the spider never gave up and eventually made it to the top. Cool! Let's splash into the next story. Pete goes to the beach with his family, but he's scared to get in the water. Will seeing his brother have fun change his mind? Let's find out as we read Pete the Cat, Pete at the Beach, created by James Dean. It is a hot day. Pete the Cat goes to the beach with his mom and his brother Bob.
"Let's go in the water," Bob says.
"Maybe later,"
says Pete. Bob likes to surf. He rides the big waves.
It looks like fun.
I'm hot, says Pete.
Go in the water, says Mom.
Maybe later, says Pete.
Pete makes a sand castle. His mom helps him dig.
Here comes a big wave, and there goes Pete.
Oh no! Where did his sand castle go?
Bob rides a big wave.
Wow, says Pete. That looks like fun.
Pete and his mom take a walk. They find seashells. They see a crab. Pete's feet get wet. His feet feel cool. The rest of him is hot. It is time for lunch. Pete eats a sandwich. He drinks lemonade. The sun is very hot, and Pete is very, very hot. Bob is wet and cool.
Let's play ball, says Pete.
No thanks, says Bob. I want to surf.
Pete throws the ball. His mom catches it.
Let's get our feet wet, says Mom.
Well, okay, says Pete.
The water is cool. It feels good. Pete goes in deeper.
Bob waves to Pete.
I want to show you how to surf,
he yells. Pete does not say,
maybe later.
He says,
let's do it.
Lie on the board, says Bob. Pete lies on the board.
Paddle,
says Bob. Pete paddles out. He waits for a big wave.
A big wave is coming.
Stand up, says Bob.
Pete stands up. Then Pete falls down. It was scary, but it did not hurt.
Try again later, says Bob.
Pete wants to try again now. Pete lies down again. He paddles out and waits.
Here comes a wave!
Pete stands up. This time he rides the wave.
Good job,
says Bob. Pete wants to surf all day. Bob does too. So they take turns. Pete and Bob rock and roll with the waves. What a great day! It is okay to be afraid, but it is more fun to surf.
Surf's up! Pete realized how cool being in the water was. So when his brother wanted to teach him how to surf, Pete was all in.
Uh-oh, the school playground is falling apart. Pete has plans to fix it up. We'll see how as we read Pete the Cat, Construction Destruction by James Dean.
Recess!
Pete shouts as the bell rings. But when Pete gets outside to play,
oh no! The playground is a disaster. The swings are broken, the slide is rusty, and the sandbox is full of weeds.
Pete makes plans for a new playground.
Wow! Says Principal Nancy. Can you really build that?
Not by myself, says Pete. I'm going to need some help.
Whatever you need, Pete, it's yours.
The next day, Pete arrives at the playground before school. The construction crew is already there. He gives them the go-ahead to tear down the old playground.
Rumble, rumble,
honk.
Creak,
crash.
Down goes the slide.
Clink,
clank.
Down go the swings.
Bang, boom.
Down goes the tower.
Honk, honk.
A truck arrives to recycle the metal.
Rumble, rumble,
honk, honk.
The new playground equipment has arrived. It's time to get to work. The cement mixer will pour concrete. The dump truck will bring sand and dirt. The backhoe will dig. The whole team will get the job done.
Clunk! Whack! Thud!
Building a playground is hard work. The new playground is cool, but it's not cool enough.
What do you think?
Pete asks, holding up his latest plans.
It will be too hard to build, says one of the workers. And everything is almost finished, says another.
But it will make this the best playground ever, Pete says.
Then let's do it,
the workers say. Screwdrivers twist in screws. Wrenches tighten the nuts. The workers try to make everything perfect.
Hooray!
The new playground is ready. Everyone is amazed until...
Creak! Creak! Creak!
Smash!
Crunch! Thud!
Oh no!
Says Principal Nancy as the new playground crashes to the ground.
The pieces are all mixed up!
Everyone is disappointed, except for Pete.
It's not how we planned it!
Pete shouts.
It's even better!
This playground is filled with surprises and places to explore. The school playground is the most amazing playground ever! Sometimes you've got to dare to dream big.
What a cool playground! Pete learned that sometimes things don't go as planned, but can turn out even better. Dream big!
In the next story, Pete loves to draw. He decides to draw pictures of his friends. Let's find out what they think of his artwork as we read Pete the Cat Crayons Rock by Kimberly and James Dean.
Pete loves his big box of groovy crayons. He loves to draw things like cars, trucks, flowers, and trees. And most of all, the big blue sea. From rocking red to cool cat blue, with a box of crayons, there's nothing Pete can't do. One day, Pete decided to draw something new.
His friends!
Using lots of colors is so much fun. Pete wanted to use everyone. He scribbled and drew a great big smile. His drawings were groovy and rocking with style.
Crayons rock!
Pete was proud of the pictures he drew. He hoped his friends would dig them too. Pete showed Grumpy Toad first. Grumpy Toad said,
"This doesn't look right. Those colors are way too bright."
Pete thought,
"Hey, no sweat. That's all right. The next one will be dynamite."
Pete showed Gus his picture, too. Gus asked,
"Who is this supposed to be? It doesn't really look like me."
Pete thought,
"Hey, no sweat. That's all right. The next one will be just right."
Pete finally showed Callie her picture. Callie said,
"This one is fine, but it feels like something's missing from mine."
Pete said,
"What a mess! Bummer. I guess my drawings aren't the best."
Pete started to frown. He put his crayons down. In art class, the teacher asked,
"Pete, what are you going to make?"
"I don't know. I'm afraid of making a mistake."
Pete looked around. Gus drew the coolest superheroes. Callie's flowers were awesome, out of sight. Grumpy's motorcycle was just right. Pete's heart sank. His paper was blank. The gang looked at Pete and said,
"No sweat, it's all right.
It doesn't have to be just right.
Your art is cool because it's you.
Your art is so unique.
Grab your groovy box of crayons.
Show us your technique.
The teacher agreed.
Art should be fun. Art is for everyone. From rocking red to cool cat blue, with a box of crayons, there's nothing you can't do.
Pete smiled.
There are no rules. It's no big deal. Art is about how it makes you feel.
Pete loved his cool art. That's the one thing Pete knew. Suddenly, Pete knew exactly what to do.
He tried again.
Instead of drawing them one by one, Pete drew the whole gang just having fun.
Wow! Way to go, Pete! That's a rocking masterpiece!
Grumpy Toad, Gus, and Callie agreed. Pete's picture was off the charts. See, that's the groovy thing about art. The best art comes from the heart. Crayons rock! Do you like to color?
Yeah!
So do I. Pete became discouraged to create artwork because of what his friends had to say. Then he learned that art is about how it makes you feel. Rock on, Pete! In the next story, we will join Pete on his first trip to the library in Pete the Cat Checks Out the Library by James Dean. Pete's mom is taking him to the library for the first time. The librarian gives Pete his very own library card.
Cool!
Says Pete. The librarian smiles. Time for the tour. The librarian takes Pete through the library. There is a big desk where people wait to check out books. Pete sees some of his friends reading at a long table. It's very peaceful and quiet. How relaxing! The librarian takes Pete to her favorite room. There are lots of Pete-sized chairs and tables and shelves. There are books of every shape, size, and color.
What do I do now? Pete asks.
Now you read a book, the librarian says.
Which book should I read?
Asks Pete. You can read any book you like, says the librarian. Pete looks around. There are so many books. Pete picks up a book all about airplanes and jets. He reads it and pretends he's a stunt pilot. He flies a super fast jet and does loop-de-loops and spirals high in the sky. Then Pete finds a book with dragons, wizards, and unicorns on the cover. He reads it and imagines that he is a powerful wizard, using magic spells and a special wand to defend his castle against a fire-breathing dragon. Next, Pete opens up a book about spiders and insects. He reads it and imagines that he is a scientist studying all types of critters in the wild. He has to be very still to study some critters, and very fast to study others. Then Pete chooses a book with all sorts of scary monsters on the cover. It is a book of fairy tales. Pete reads it and pretends that he is in a dark, spooky forest trying to outsmart a big, bad wolf. Pete puts that book back on the shelf. It is too scary. Pete opens up a book about the pyramids in Egypt. He reads it and pretends that he is an explorer riding a camel across the desert and climbing to the top of a giant pyramid. Next, Pete picks a book with all sorts of robots on the cover. He reads it and imagines that he is a robot at a robot dance party. His arms and legs make whizzing sounds when he moves. When Robot Pete speaks, he says,
"Bleep, bloop, bleep."
Next, Pete picks up a book about superheroes. He reads it and makes believe that he is a superhero. He flies around the city in a colorful cape, chasing bad guys and saving the day. Then Pete spots a big book about the ocean and all its creatures. He reads it and imagines that he is a scientist in a submarine deep in the Atlantic Ocean, looking for whales, squids, and sharks. There are so many wonderful books to read at the library. Pete can be whatever he imagines with a book. Reading is super groovy! Do you like to visit the library?
Yeah!
I do too! Pete read so many different books and had so much fun using his imagination. Reading is awesome! In the next story, Pete has a new neighbor. Will they become friends? Let's find out as we read Pete the Cat and the New Guy by Kimberly and James Dean. It was Sunday and Pete's friends had come to play. They were rocking to a new song when... Beep, beep, beep! There was a noise coming from across the street. Wise Old Owl had a view from his tree. Pete said,
"Hey Owl, what do you see?"
Owl said, "All I see are green shoes and a red hat." Pete answered,
"Sounds like my kind of cat."
Pete could not imagine who this new guy could be.
"I really hope it's a new friend for me."
On Monday, Pete wanted to say hi, but he was feeling kind of shy. So he just rode by and by and by and by until finally Pete got to meet the new guy. Pete said,
"I've never met anyone quite like you. You seem like a duck and like a beaver too."
The new guy said to Pete,
"Hi, my name is Gus. Glad to meet you. I'm a platypus."
Pete said,
"You're not like me and I am not like you. But I think being different is really very cool."
On Tuesday, Pete and Gus took a walk down the street. They came to Squirrel, who was playing in a tree.
"Hi, Gus,"
said Squirrel.
"Climbing is easy. Try and see."
Gus gave the tree a try, but the branch was way too high.
"I wish I could climb like you, but climbing is something I just can't do."
Pete said,
"Don't be sad. Don't be blue. There is something everyone can do."
On Wednesday, Pete and Gus took a walk down the street. They came to Pete's friend Grumpy Toad, who said,
"Come play leapfrog with me. Jumping is easy. Try and see."
Gus jumped and leaped, but he couldn't get over Toad or Pete.
"I wish I could jump like you. But jumping is something I just can't do."
Pete said,
"Don't be sad. Don't be blue. There is something everyone can do."
On Thursday, Pete and Gus took a walk down the street. Soon they saw Octopus, who said,
"Come juggle with me. Juggling is easy. Try and see."
"I wish I could juggle like you. But juggling is something I just can't do."
Pete said,
"Don't be sad. Don't be blue. There is something everyone can do."
On Friday, Pete and Gus took a walk down the street. Gus said,
"I can't juggle or jump or climb a tree. It's no fun around here for me."
On Saturday, Pete hoped Gus would come out to play.
"I wish Gus wasn't sad. I wish Gus wasn't blue. I wish there was something we could do."
Just then, Pete heard a groovy sound. It was coming from across the street. Gus was rocking to his own beat. "Sweet!"
Pete said, "Check out Gus the platypus! He found something cool he can do with us!"
Tap, thump, thump. Tap, thump, thump, tap.
"He's not sad. He's not blue. Gus found something that everyone can do."
I like that story.
Me too.
So did I.
Gus was sad that he couldn't juggle, jump, or climb a tree. But in the end, Gus found something they all could do together. Let's dive into the next story. Pete is going scuba diving. Let's find out what he sees as we read Pete the Cat Scuba Cat by James Dean.
Pete the Cat is excited. He is going scuba diving.
Pete puts on a mask and fins.
He has a tank full of air. He hopes to see lots of fish.
If you are lucky, you might see a seahorse, says Captain Joe.
A seahorse? Says Pete. I can't wait! I never saw him before!
Their ridges look like a horse's mane, says Captain Joe.
Groovy! Says Pete. Pete jumps into the water. Splash! Down, down, down he goes. Up, up, up go the bubbles. Pete looks for a seahorse. He sees a swordfish. Pete swims out of its way. Pete waves to a stingray. It has a long, skinny tail. That's not a seahorse, thinks Pete. Pete looks high and low for the seahorse. Then he feels a tickle. Pete sees a school of fish. They all look alike, except for one. It puffs up. It is a blowfish. It is not a seahorse. Where could one be? Pete looks in the rocks. What is that? It is an octopus. It has 8 legs. It is not a seahorse. Pete feels a tickle. What could it be? Pete turns. He sees a cave. Is there a seahorse inside? Pete sees a crab with claws. A seahorse does not have claws, Pete thinks. The cave is getting darker. Pete feels a tickle. Then he sees an eel. Pete swims past it. It is too long to be a seahorse. Oh no! It is too dark to see! How will Pete get out? Pete sees a jellyfish. It glows in the dark. Pete is almost out of the cave. He sees an angelfish. It is very colorful. Pete is out of the cave. So why is it so dark? Pete is in a shadow. He is in the shadow of a whale. Yikes! Pete wishes he could jump on a seahorse and ride away. Pete hops on a sea turtle instead. It takes him to the boat. I did not see a seahorse, thinks Pete. He feels a tickle on his tail. A seahorse! Cries Pete. What a surprise!
You were with me all along, says Pete. What a cool adventure!
What an amazing story!
Yeah!
Pete saw so many underwater creatures. He had hoped to see a seahorse, and at the end of his exploration, he finally did. Moving on, there is trouble at the warehouse. The mayor needs Super Pete's help. Let's find out if he saves the day as we read Pete the Cat, Super Pete by Kimberly and James Dean. Pete the Cat is out for a walk. Pete listens to the owls. He listens to the frogs. Just then, Pete hears a beep. It is not coming from outside. It is coming from his watch. Pete races home. It is time for Pete the Cat to become Super Pete. Pete presses a button in his room. The wall slides away. Pete sees a set of steps. Down, down, down he goes. Pete steps into his lair. It is full of groovy things to help him fight crime. Pete the Cat puts on his awesome cat suit. He puts on his cape and his sneakers. Now Super Pete is ready to save the city. Pete sees a flashing light. There is a message on his computer. It is the mayor.
Come quick, Super Pete, the mayor says.
We need your help. There is trouble at the warehouse.
Pete pulls a lever.
Whoosh!
Pete's nifty jet sinks into his lair. Pete hops into the jet. He zips into the air. Super Pete is on his way to save the day. Pete races through the sky. He hits a button. The jet shimmers. The jet disappears. Now the jet is invisible. No one will know Super Pete is coming. Pete hovers over the warehouse. He straps on a parachute. He jumps. Pete lands on the roof. He goes inside the warehouse. It is dark. He cannot see. Pete puts on his night vision goggles. He sees two bad guys. They are carrying a box. Pete picks up a rock. He puts it in his slingshot. The rock hits the box. The bad guys drop the box. They climb out a window. Pete races to the window. The bad guys have a boat. They are getting away. Pete pushes a button on his catsuit. His sneakers turn to flippers. A mask closes over his face. Pete jumps into the water. He swims after the bad guys. Pete takes a rope from his pocket. He twirls it over his head. Pete aims. He throws. The rope catches the boat. Pete pulls himself along the rope. Pete climbs into the bad guy's boat. He ties up the bad guys. Pete pushes a button on his watch. His jet appears above him. Pete pulls the bad guys into his jet. Pete brings the bad guys to the mayor. Super Pete saved the day!
The bad guys are no match for Super Pete. He caught the bad guys and saved the day.
Way to go, Super Pete!
In our final story, there is no school because it's a snow day. Pete has so much fun playing in the snow, but not for long.
We'll find out what happens as we read
Pete the Cat Snow Days by James Dean. Pete the Cat wakes up and gets ready for school. He has show and tell today.
There is no school today,
says Pete's mom.
It's a snow day.
Hooray!
Yells Pete.
Let's go sledding, says Pete.
Great idea,
says his brother, Bob. Pete puts on his hat, boots, and mittens.
I'm ready to go,
he says. On the way, Pete makes snowballs. He throws one at Bob. Bob throws one back. Pete makes a snow cat.
Snow days are way more fun than school days, he says. Sledding Hill, here we come, says Pete.
He can't wait to get there. Pete waves to Callie.
Come sledding with us,
he says. The hill is big. Trey and Emma look small at the top. Crunch, crunch goes the snow as Pete, Bob, and Callie go up, up, up.
Whee!
They yell as they go down, down, down.
I love snow days, says Pete.
On the way home, Pete and Bob stop at Trey's house. The hot chocolate is yummy.
What a fun day, says Pete. Tomorrow at school, I'll tell my class all about it.
Pete wakes up to more snow. It's not a school day. It's another snow day. Pete makes a snow fort. He throws snowballs. He makes a snow dog. Then he has fun sledding. He can't wait to tell his teacher about it. But the next day is a snow day too.
There's too much snow,
Pete and Bob can barely even open the front door. Before you go sledding, please shovel the walk, says Mom. But shoveling is hard work. When Pete is done, he's too tired to go sledding. Pete misses his teacher. He misses the other cats in his class. Pete can't wait to go back to school tomorrow. But when Pete wakes up, it's snowing.
Oh no, he says. Not another snow day?
Pete wants to go to school, so Pete plows the streets all by himself. The other cats rush outside. They help clear the snow. Everyone wants to go to school. The streets are clear and safe. The bus can drive. School is open! All the kids are excited to see their teacher. He has a snow day show and tell. When it's Pete's turn, he tells everyone about the fun he had in the snow.
I love snow days, says Pete, but I love school best.
Do you like playing in the snow?
I do!
Me too! Pete loved the first snow day, but by the third snow day, he was ready to go back to school. School is awesome! Thank you all so much for joining us. It's Sweet Pea's bedtime. Good night, Sweet Pea, and good night to all of you.
Sweet Pea!
Please like and subscribe.